What up, what up, what up? It's your boy Steven.
And Kessa.
And this is Uniquely Weird. And today we'll be doing one of our first, I guess you could say, AITAs. Am I the A-holes? Mm-hmm. It's technically our first one because we're not doing it to a reaction to an Am I the A-hole story. So we'll be reading it straight off the screen. You can read it with us and you can tell us how you feel about the situation as well.
Right. Okay. So, today's Am I...
Thank you.
Okay.
Let me just get in here some.
Oh. All right. Pushed you out of the screen. Today's Am I the A-hole is... Let's see.
Yeah, let's go. Like the air ammo.
Oh, thought it was major. Mm-mm. Okay. So, it says, I've been with my BF for... Oh, shoot. Hold on. Take two.
Do you want to read this or you want me to read it?
I want to talk more.
Go ahead.
Okay. I've been with my boyfriend just about 4 years. We've been... on a total of two dates. Two. I have just been asking for 3 years now about going on dates. Monday, late afternoon, he promised that after my interview yesterday, we would go on mini golfing. It didn't happen. He says he doesn't remember saying we will, but my youngest daughter, 13, heard it. Keep in mind, he was drinking beer most of the day Monday. But yesterday, he said he wasn't feeling the greatest. Beer, hello. Where am I? But can go shoot pool with two of his cousins. He left at 7:15 p.m. and at 11, he said he'll be home in a bit. I was waiting for him to get home and couldn't sleep. I left at 2:45 a.m. down the road. Oh, to drive down the road. To find him, and he got home right after I left. I chewed his A out because he promised a date yesterday, but felt well enough to shoot pool instead. Am I the a-hole for being pissed? Am I the a-hole for telling him what I want / need, then getting pissed when he blows it off? Well,
go ahead.
No, you're not the a-hole. I definitely think he's the a-hole in this situation. Like, first of all, you've been with him for 2 years and only been on two dates. Oh, 4 years. You've been with him for 4 years and only been on two dates. Why? Like,
that's actually pretty neglecting at that point. Like, y'all been together for 4 years and you've been on two total dates. At that point, I think he thinks that you have accepted the fact that y'all don't date that much. Like, it's almost like he feels like you'll get over it. And he's basically taking advantage of the fact that, you know, you just get over it every time he just blows it off and goes to shoot pool with his cousins or does whatever it is that he decides to do. He blows it off and he just neglects your feelings on that. Does that make you the a-hole? No. That makes you a reasonable woman who actually wants to spend some time with your boyfriend. That's all that makes you. And you chewing him out is, you know, that seems like the right thing to do. You know, first off, he left at 7:15. Mm-hmm. At 11, he said he was going to be home. Like, I've had my nights where I've told Kes, you know, I'll be on the way back. You know, and then I may have came back an hour or two after the time that I said I was about to leave. Because, you know, sometimes, you know,
yeah,
close people,
happen.
You start talking, you can't just get out the door immediately. That happens. Mm-hmm. But
she went looking for him at 2:45 a.m., driving down the road to find him. And then he got home after she left. Like, she felt the need to have to leave.
Yeah.
To go look for him.
The fact that she felt that need, she was worried about him and stuff, and he showed up after, is just like, it's disrespectful almost. And then, like, you're not keeping in communication. I get it. Sometimes your phone dies. I get that. But, like, it's certain things. Like, you're taking for granted your woman's love for you, in a sense. Mm-hmm. And that's not even to take the woman's side or whatever you would say. You're taking for granted the goodness that she gives you, you know, the grace that she gives you.
Mm-hmm.
And
oh, she giving lots of grace.
Oh man, two dates, 4 years.
That's a whole bunch of grace.
Two dates. We've done more than two dates this year alone.
Yeah.
By the last far.
2 months.
Shoot, the last 2 months, we've probably done 3, 4, 5 of them. I don't know. Mm. Yeah.
We just be going to eat. We yeah. like to eat.
Go out to eat, go to eat sushi, stuff like that. Like, that's unhealthy. Dating is necessary. And I'm married and I still, like, we've been together since, what, 2013? And we still go on dates frequent. Like, it's just, it's healthy for your relationship. It's
definitely.
I feel like it's the route you need to take. So, are you the a-hole for that? Definitely not. Like, no. What?
I think it's healthy for her to chew him out. Well, I don't know. This is just a snippet of what she's going through, right? Mm-hmm. So, I don't... Did she say that she, you know, mentions it a lot? Like, she tells him, I want to go on a date. Like,
I've been asking... So, she right. goes... Second line says, right. I have been asking for three years now so, about I mean, going out on dates.
So, no. Because I was going to... At first, I was going to say, you can't just chew him out and you've never, like, said, I want to do this. But she's been asking for 3 years to go on dates and she finally decides to chew him out. Says, chew him out and leave. Like, just go. At this point, just...
Because at this... Like, it's kind of like burning, like rubbing onto the fact that it's kind of your fault that this situation is still going on as well, because you're putting up with it. Like mm-hmm. you are, because you've been asking for 3 years to go on a date with a man when you could have easily just been like, all right, cool. Well, if that's not something you're into and that's not something you really are willing to do for me, then hey, then I'm just going to move on and go to the next guy, you know, like, the one that will. Because two dates in 4 years is ridiculous. I'm
what else
sorry.
Does he do for her? I want to know.
Yeah.
What else does he do for you that, like, makes you want to stay for 4 years without three dates? Like, two what and four? I wonder if those two dates, I bet those two dates happened in the first year. Like, he took her in the first year.
She's right, been so asking for 3 years.
To go on another date. Girl, and then you have a daughter. A 13-year-old daughter, right, that, like, you have to set an example for, right? So, that's not a healthy example of a relationship you want to set for your daughter either. So, no, not the a-hole. Move on. That's my take on that.
Not the a-hole. Take care of yourself, your mental health, and your physical health, your relationship status, all that good stuff. Take care of yourself at the end of the day, because you're putting too much, I guess, what's the word? You're not really looking, you're not looking out for yourself enough at this point. And he's taking advantage of you in a sense, based on what we've gotten, mm-hmm. based on the information that we have, like it's almost like he's taking advantage of you. Like you've 3 years. Like, what else can I say? What do y'all think in the comments? Let us know down below what y'all think about this situation right here. We'll be doing a lot more of these. We actually have a lot more coming up. So let us know if you think she's the a-hole or if he's the a-hole or what you think about this entire situation.
All right. Well, like you said, comment. Like it if you like it. Dislike it if you dislike it. But subscribe. Okay, bye.
We're on that 200 grind.
Oh, yeah.
Peace.